This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part three of how to convert angles between decimal degrees and degrees, minutes, and seconds. And in this video, we're going to convert the following angles given in degrees, minutes, and seconds to decimal degrees, and we're going to round to the nearest thousandth if needed. So first of all, remember that there are 60 minutes in a degree, so each minute is 1/60th of a degree. Oops, I wrote the wrong thing here. And then we've got 60 seconds in 1 minute, so each second is 1/60th of a minute, which means it's 1/3600th of a degree. Okay? So here's the quick and easy way to do this. You know the 52 degrees is, it's still going to be 52 point something, right? So you know that's not going to change. So the thing you really have to work on is the 30 minutes and the 24 seconds. You're going to have to add that decimal part on. So I'm just going to write this out. You could think of it as adding these three parts together. But you know the whole number part isn't going to change. It's going to be 52 degrees. So we have 52 degrees, and I want to first change this minutes, 30 minutes, to degrees. And from the previous two videos, hopefully you realize, since there is 1/60th of a degree right up here in a minute, you could simply put 30 over 60, and you'll have your answer in degrees. Now, what about these seconds? Well, each second is 1/3600th of a degree. So it's like you're changing that to degrees. You're going to have to divide by 3600. So this will be 24/3600ths. And that'll now be in degrees. So you're going to have to do this computation here, 3/60ths plus 24/3600ths. That's going to be some decimal number. And then you're going to be able to attach that to the 52 point something. So you have to be careful in your calculator. So it depends on what kind of calculator you have, but I'm not going to put the 52 because I know that my answer is the whole number part's going to be 52 already. So I'm going to say this is going to be 52. And actually, it's not going to equal it. We are going to have to round here, I think. So it's 52 point. So my scientific calculator, calculator, let's get that right. You could put 30 divided by 60 plus 24 divided by 300 and see what comes up. And my calculator came up with 50, and I'm going to round to the nearest thousandth, 507. And now it is all in degrees, rounded to the nearest thousandth, which were the directions. Now, notice that 3/60th right here of a degree, in other words, 30 minutes, that's like a half an hour, right? So it's a half a degree, which is 0.5, so it seems like it's right. We've got the 0.5 part, and then this 24 seconds is really tiny. That's this little extra piece here. So that seems like a reasonable answer. So that is our answer rounded to the nearest thousandth. Of a degree. So here's our second problem. You want to do it exactly the same way. So we know this is 178 degrees, which we're not going to do much with that. We don't need to put that in the calculator, the whole number part. But 16 minutes and 5 seconds written in degree form could be 16. Well, there's 60 minutes in a degree, so it's just 1/16. Now it's in degrees. And then 5, all right, so in a second is 1/3600th of a degree, so that's why we have to divide by 3600 degrees. So basically you want to enter The whole number, right? If you want, you could put 178 plus 16 over 60 plus 5 over 3600, and you'll get the whole answer. Or you could just write the 178. You know, that part's going to be there, which is just the way I like to do it. So you want to enter that in your calculator, and then you want to round it to the nearest thousandth, which is three places after the decimal point. So get out your calculator and do that. And I'm doing it as I'm talking to you. And I have 0.268. Now I rounded it. So since I rounded it, I'm going to change this and write it's approximately equal to that. And that's how you can always change from degrees, minutes, and seconds to just a decimal number here. Now, on the next video, we're going to go from a decimal number to minutes and or seconds, and that's a little bit more complicated, but make sure that you look at those videos as well. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.